The Galaxy Note 8 is the hottest new Samsung phone in town. This towering handset is the latest representative of Sammy's new design philosophy, packing a 6.3-inch Infinity display with extra-thin bezels at the front. However, this reduction in bezel size means that the phone's lower chin can no longer host the physical Samsung Home Key that was typical for all of its predecessors. Instead, there's an on-screen button that simulates a haptic press via a smart vibration engine. Previously, one had to simultaneously press and hold the home key and power lock button to take a screenshot. However, the new design of the Note 8 has forced a change in the key combination. So, how does one take a screen grab on a Note 8? Let's find out in that video. Number 1, the classic way but with a twist. The new way of doing it through the physical buttons is by pressing the power lock key, right side, and the volume down button, left side, at once. Hold them down for a moment and you'll see the screen flash. Number 2, use the dedicated gesture features offered by your Samsung Galaxy Note 8. Of course, if you're not a fan of the button combination, there's also a way of capturing a screenshot via a gesture. It's called palm swipe to capture and it's pretty self-explanatory, just swipe the edge of your hand across the phone's screen, while making sure that you keep contact with it throughout the whole motion. You should have this feature enabled by default on your Note 8, but if you aren't able to take a screenshot that way, go to Settings then Advanced Options and see if the gesture is toggled on. Number 3, ask for assistance to Bixby, your intelligent voice assistant on the Galaxy Note 8. Last but not least, you can also ask Bixby to take a screenshot for you. Summon Samsung's artificial intelligence assistant by saying "Hi Bixby," only works if you've gone through the Bixby setup, or by pressing and holding the dedicated button on the left side. Then, simply say "Take a screenshot" and you're all set. Alright, so you've successfully taken a screenshot, now what? Well, you might have noticed that a preview menu will appear in the first few seconds after a screen grab. This menu gives you the possibility of editing anything you've captured via three tools. The first one, from left to right, is a scrolling screenshot. Tap on that button and the phone will scroll down and automatically capture anything that appears on the display. This is particularly useful for recording things like long lists or web pages. Icon number 2 represents a draw option. Naturally, it allows you to draw on top of a screenshot, which is nice if you want to highlight something. Last but not least, you have the crop tool. Tap on the crop button and you will see a preview with the on-screen buttons and system information on the top taskbar automatically cropped. Of course, you can make your selection larger or smaller, but the default option is good enough for those of you who just want to avoid having that extra stuff present on the screenshot. Which solution do you prefer for taking screenshots on the Samsung Galaxy Note 8? Let us know your thoughts and comments. To discover more Samsung and Android tips, don't hesitate to subscribe to the S. Sorrells channel.